This clacking sound made by the streets of Qintong is revered by the locals. Outsiders may not be aware that it has helped protect Qintong for centuries. Thieves used to be rampant in Qintong. They would go door to door on raids at night. But people discovered the clacking brick laid roads functioned as a kind of burglar alarm. With the clacking streets, people could again sleep peacefully. Thieves would set off the metallic sound, allowing the villagers to mobilize and drive them off. This sound has since become a trademark of Qintong. Qintong lies in Jiangyan in central Jiangsu province. It is 160 kilometers from Nanjing, 240 kilometers from Shanghai, and 80 kilometers north of the famous Yangtze River. 80 kilometers to its east is the coast of the East China Sea. This old brick road in his ancestral home inspired Qian Sunda to take an interest in Qintong bricks. He has since built up a remarkable collection. He believes the bricks are the keys and stepping stones to unlocking the secrets of Qintong's history and culture. Walking among the bricks and tiles of Qintong is like entering another world. Among the bricks is hidden a story of great wealth. If you're lucky enough to find bricks inscribed with the Yu family seal, you jump back 200 years in time. In the Qing Dynasty, about 300 years ago, the Liu family produced two top military officials that built the largest residence in Qintong. But it was later made into a granary. In the old days, everybody in Qintong was involved in brick production. Those wealthy enough built kilns. Farmers got rich from burning bricks rather than farming. At its peak, Qintong had over 200 kilns. The Liu brothers opened 14 kilns, enough to build their huge home and get rich exporting bricks to the neighboring lands.
Oh, 这么一个什么的麒麟，麒麟，这是有另一种说法，文的是文官是禽，禽类，就是柳青啊之类的，五官就是兽类，这个麒麟好像是在五官里头级别最高的，
他是武状元，他是兽，
哎呦，那这是什么呢？这是干什么的？这个扭转员，他这个拧的这个拧弓师，
练功是？
哎，拧弓师，他是当时是这样的举起来，这样的举起来，我的，哎，你搬不动，
那您来试，
我肯定也不可能，没有，目前没有人能搬，不可以，很沉的。
村里有人能搬得动吗？没起名，他要练的话得把这耍起来吧。哎，对，你这把这有多少斤呢？他这得有350斤呢。他这得有300斤，头号三百斤。那现在换算现在就是150公斤。哎呀，不行，太吃力，两个人太吃力了。一个人就能耍起来，当个武状元还真要气力过人呢。
The Liu family's kilns still burn bright in Qintong people's memories. Their fires help shape not only the fortune of the Liu family, they are the foundation of the town of Qintong, giving it the distinctive olive hue and the unique chiming sound when the bricks are struck. Brick production is the town's main source of wealth, and it has brought 100 years of development. 这是不是最近这东西还在。The town's most vibrant days are now behind it, but in its heyday, it attracted wealthy merchants traveling between Nanjing and Shanghai. 19th century, the prosperous town of Qintong was nicknamed Little Shanghai. Businessmen set up offices here. Qintong used to be the biggest distribution center for grain and oil around Shanghai. But the accumulation of wealth also attracted thieves, so visiting merchants preferred the safety of staying with rich families.
过去解放军有一种不好的一种社会行为叫抬财神，你知道不？就绑票。绑票。我们这里叫抬财神，有钱的就把你抬走了，然后拿钱回来赎。所以说主人把他安排在这个最保险的、最高档的房间，这个里面住。
这么棒。
那现在我帮你介绍一下，这个墙面呢，实际上它是主人起房的时候，一个密室。
密室，
走过来换，您看，很巧，没有的设计这个密室。密室当时的主人的目的是什么呢？是这个房子啊，小偷里面藏一些字画、古玩、金银细软。这样呢，就是说，我们这个地方因为毕竟靠近海边嘛，它这个海盗啊，经常呢骚扰侵扰我们，就是能够到这个密室里面能够躲藏躲避一生。
Bricks brought wealth and prosperity to Qintong. Bricks were made everywhere. So what made Qintong's bricks so special? This is Qintong, the town of musical bricks. During the annual Qintong Boat Festival, oars and stakes fill Lake Qin. The tourists flocking to the lake bring new business opportunities. Just like the wealth buried at the bottom of the lake brought riches to the town in earlier days.
泥是的，那么粘的。泥干啥？啥的？有泥土的。都这样的吗？秦湖底和底都这样的吗？秦湖底下的这个泥种自然的，都是这样。哦，那个都是什么人喜欢这种粘土啊？这个时候做那个种子，那个种子，我就是种黄的。为什么那些做砖做瓦的人都喜欢这种泥啊？
这种泥做的土的不泥土。
不裂缝，
只要刮灰，手里种子只要刮灰，懂吧？
那别的泥土呢？
别的泥土那个像那个青头，它就用是生的泥土，那个风到那个种子就不行了，生的就不行了。
您家里住的是砖房吗？
我家住的是砖房，
是这种泥烧的吗？
是的，肯定是的。
哦，
那青龙能吃，青龙的种子不用，青龙的是吧？肯定用的。这不是胶吗？它就是泥，它就是泥土的，加有沙土，它属于泥。
粘在我的手上。
它泥干啥？它就是不要泥，一头。
这胶，这不是泥。
一脚一泥。
Nobody knows who first used Lake Qin mud to fire bricks, but locals quickly realized it was good quality mud. People here say Qintong was born of and prospered on the bricks made from it. It's as fine as flour, completely without impurities, earning it the nickname Qintong Gold Bars.
这在我们地表以下10公尺以下的，叫浮相沉积土。浮相沉积土就是大海冻结以后啊，它的这个形成了一种沉淀的湖泊，我们叫泻湖，慢慢就形成一种淤积的泥土。这种泥土纯天然的，
它跟那个秦湖那些芦苇生长了、倒伏了、倒伏了生长有关系？有吗？你们就有芦苇的。
The mud from Lake Qin was instrumental in helping create the extraordinary Qintong bricks. Why did people here imprint their bricks with these mysterious marks?
双斧，双双的，一把斧就不好看，这是对称的，双斧了。哦，你看这边还有一个。嗯，因为我们在秦通的很多地方，那墙上、老砖上都发现这个标志，这跟秦通的砖有什么样的关系呢？
它这就是现在说白就是商标。 就是现在的商标注册是商标，到外地方看到我们这个只要是有双斧的，就是我们晴东的砖。你看上海的城隍庙，南京的鸡鸣寺，镇江的金山，你都可以找到我们晴东砖头的这一种痕迹。All
the main historical buildings for hundreds of miles around use Qintong bricks. They are all imprinted with the double axe. This Buddhist temple has stood by Qintong for centuries. It has been destroyed several times, but always rebuilt using Qintong bricks. The brick's consistent quality ensures its unchanging appearance. Bricks brought great wealth to Qintong. But the people here also added value to the bricks. tile carvings are a ubiquitous sight in Qintong. The Lake Qin mud built this town and its clacking bricks. But it also helped promote a special profession, the tile carver. Without the olive Qintong bricks, Tian De Tai would probably have a different job. Despite this price, Qintong people have the door headings and other tiles around their houses carved. Qian Sunde collects these carvings and can't bear to see the art disappear. This high quality gave rise to the tile carvers. All good tile carvers can tell the quality of a tile just by listening. Just as the clear sound of the bricks prevented burglary, box trees are said to prevent fires. This is Qintong, the town of musical bricks. As Qintong prospered, security became of ever greater importance. The chiming bricks warned of intruders, and incredibly, certain type of tree were said to prevent fires. Every household relied on them. This is the first time the crew has heard of anything like this. Qian Sunde believes the tree is non-flammable. The crew cuts a twig from the tree and burns some newspapers to begin the experiment. It seems the box tree does burn after all, but maybe the noise it gives off serves as a fire alarm. The town is very compact and has experienced several large fires. The box trees were planted to alert people and reduce the damage. Over the years, the town has changed. The kilns are cold, and earth is no longer dug to make tiles. But Qintong won't fade so easily. Today, tourists pack its streets and alleys. Is still busy. The clay miners have been replaced by boat women. Xu Wulin feels the changes Qintong is going through. Before, everybody had a boat, but they used poles rather than oars. Since tourism began to pick up, the boat women found their place sculling the visitors around. Qintong is still a serene place. The bricks record the town's resplendent past, just like the water surface reflects its beautiful present and future. In the eyes of the locals, not much has changed over the centuries, except that the kilns have been replaced by boat women and their boats.